What up, what up, what up, fellow agents? Pure Prime here. Oh yes, our first vendors of TU10, and they are beautiful. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content, really appreciate it. And today, yes, TU10 is here. And it brings a lot of good things with it, and especially the vendors. Yes, guys, of course, it's Tuesday, we got a vendor reset, and we got a lot of good stuff to buy. So I hope you collected a lot of in-game money, because we will visit every vendor, guys. Yes, at every vendor, we can buy something that is definitely worth your travel and your money. And guys, make sure to dive in directly to your vendors, because the last few big updates, they released a maintenance within a few hours of the update, and then all the vendors were normal again or were different again. And every time at the beginning, there were god rolls to be found. And now we got a lot of maxed out attributes, gear, whatever brand sets, and of course all the new gear sets, or almost all new gear sets we can buy this week in the vendor reset. But let's start with the White House, guys. Let's see, first thing, the Emmeline's Guard named SMG, and right off the bat, 15% SMG damage. The cap of an SMG then, of course. 10.5% critical hit chance and 2.9% rate of fire, and perfect preservation on there because it's Emmeline's Guard, so it's the named SMG. In my opinion, that critical hit chance should be a little bit higher, because that fire rate, you want that gone and get something else for there. But that 15% SMG damage, guys, if you still don't have it, pick it up and roll it in your library. MP7, pretty decent, better than we of course had before, but yeah, I don't know if it's worth the 8.5k. Then we got the ACR again, 15% assault rifle damage maxed out, 6.5% health damage and 9% headshot damage and ranger on there. And this could be a very nice buy if you are going for the ACR and then of course for the headshots. You got some attribute with headshot damage on there, and then roll that health damage to the max cap, and you have a very decent ACR. Then we got the 93R. It's a pistol, but you can buy it for the new talent, Future Perfect. Weapon kills grants one skill tier for 15 seconds and stacks up to 3 times. Weapon kills at skill tier 6 grant an overcharge of 15 seconds, and the overcharge cooldown is 90 seconds. So this isn't a great buy for the gun itself, but the new talent, rolled in your library and you already have it. Then we have the backpack from Alps, 10.4% skill haste, 7% skill damage, and wicked as a talent. Pretty decent, but you can find a little bit higher in the open world, especially now if you go for a higher difficulty, the rewards are very lucrative. Then we're going over to the Sokolov chest, 8% weapon damage, 7.4% status effect, and almost a max cap of health of 18.5k on there. And then of course spotter could be a little bit better, because you want that weapon damage higher or that status effect higher, so you can roll one of those. So in my opinion, just leave it here. Then the first mod of TU10, guys, 4.4% critical hit chance, pretty decent, but the open world will treat you way better. And then we got the 6.3% deflect duration for your drone, and this is a very nice buy. I didn't find that high in the open world, but to be honest, I didn't search for it, but the rest I pretty much got, so this is a very nice buy for that 4.5k if you still don't have it, of course. And then we got the 6.1% skill haste for your turret, pretty decent buy as well. And at last, the 6.4% damage for your sticky. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for the White House. So let's move over and go to the campus. So let's see what the campus sells us, guys. First thing is the Commando. 10% marksman rifle damage, 91% headshot damage, and 8.5% reload speed. And of course, perfectly naked on there because it's the named SVD. In my opinion, just leave it here, guys, because that marksman rifle damage should be higher. Headshot damage, quite nice, but could be higher as well. But you don't want that reload speed on there. Then the next one, SOCOM MK20. 11% marksman rifle damage, 92% headshot damage, and 7.5% critical hit chance, and breadbasket on there. This could be nice, but again, that marksman rifle damage and that headshot damage should be a little bit higher. But if you're still looking for a decent MK20, then definitely go for this, because that 7.5% critical hit chance is pretty nice, because you can put something else on your build instead of that critical hit chance. Then over to the classic RPK. 10% LMG damage, 10% damage to target out of cover, and 8.2% accuracy and frenzy on there. My opinion, leave it here. It's too low for that 8.5K. And then over to the new brand set, guys. Yes, Walker, Harris & Co. with the new brand set bonuses, of course, of 5% weapon damage, 5% damage to armor, and 5% damage to health. This has 13.2% weapon damage, 10.3% critical hit damage, and 5.5% weapon handling. And then, of course, with that red mod on there. In my opinion, roll that weapon handling away for some critical hit chance. Because, yeah, you wanna go for the critical hit chance a little bit more, of course, than that weapon handling, although it got a buff. But still, we need to find out if that buff is worth it to lose some critical hit chance or damage with a DPS build then, of course. Then over to the Providence holster. 9.3% weapon damage, 14.9% skill repair, and 8.8% explosive resistance. Then over to the first mod, 16.4% repair skills, 5.7% heal for your chem launcher, 4% range for your hive, and then 15.1% health for your pulse, and 4.3% duration for your shock traps. These are pretty decent, but still, the open world will treat you better. That 5.7% heal is maybe something to buy, but go in the open world, guys, because the farming got a pretty nice buff. But then let's head over to the theater. And there we are, guys. The first thing is the boomstick. 11% shotgun damage, 9% damage to armor, and 7% damage to target out of cover. And then, of course, perfect pumped up on there. Could be decent, but I would love to see a little bit higher rolls at the attribute. So leave it here, especially for that 15K. Then we got the KSG shotgun, not that great as well. As you can see, 10% shotgun damage, 9% damage to armor, and 3.8% rate of fire, and steady handed on there. The steady handed isn't the combination you want on the shotgun, and that fire rate could be something else in my opinion. And then over to the USC-45, decent rifle with perpetuation on there, but yeah, the rolls could be a little bit higher. I would love to see that rifle damage a little bit higher, or yeah, of course, that damage to target out of cover. Then over to the Araldi Holdings gloves, 10.6% weapon damage, 16.1% repair skills, and 6% weapon handling on there. Still, in my opinion, go for a better one in the open world, because you want that weapon handling a little bit higher, or of course, critical hit chance or damage on there. And then that 10.6% weapon damage is a little bit too low. And then over to the Alps knee pads, guys. 14.3k health and 7.8% status effect on there. Pretty decent, but not worth buying in my opinion. Over to the 16.6% incoming repairs. This is a pretty decent one, although in the open world the drops will give you like 17-18%, so that 4.5k is pretty high up there, but if you have enough money, still looking for this, definitely buy this. Then over to the 6.1% healing for your healing mind. This is a pretty decent one if you're using it. Then over to the 4.3% active regeneration for your shield. And this is a very nice buy. I think the highest I found was 4.4. And I put a lot of hours in this game. So this is a very nice buy, guys. Pick it up. Then over to the 1 max target. Not that great. I think most of y'all already have this. And the last one, the 6% health for your decoy. And this is a pretty decent one. The decoy is one of the underrated skills to be used because, yeah, that decoy is pretty decent and that health is pretty high up there. But let's head over to the disease, guys. Yes, the disease are worth it again to travel to. So let's start with the DZ East. So our first DZ, guys, let's see. First one is the Darkness, 10% marksman rifle, 95% headshot and 17% optimal range. And of course then perfect eyeless on there because it's the named marksman rifle. In my opinion, leave it here, especially for that 152 Dark Zone credits. And then over to the classic M44, guys. In my opinion, leave it here. Got a little bit of a buff, but I don't want that 12.2% swap speed on there. Then we got the military L86. In my opinion, again, leave it here because, again, swap speed. In my opinion, you want something else on there. And then, guys, over to our first new gear set, the biohazard mask from the Eclipse Protocol. Two pieces will give us 15% status effect, three pieces will give us 15% skill haste and 30% hazard protection, and then the four piece indirect transmission. Your status effects now spread on kill to all enemies within 15 meters and refresh 50% of that duration. So that is pretty nice, guys. But again, yeah, it's a skill tier. So if you find it, you're gonna use it with the skill tier so you can roll whatever attribute you want on there and what you think is good for this. Because in my opinion, go for some status effect or maybe some skill haste. And then we have the next one, the Rush Tactics Holster from the Future Initiative. And this gives us 30% repair skills for the two piece. The three piece will give us 15% skill haste and 30% skill duration. And the four piece will give us ground control. Increase you and your allies' total weapon and skill damage by 15% when at full armor. When you repair an ally, you and all allies within 5 meters of you are also repaired of 60% of that amount. So that looks like a very nice gear set. And this comes with 15.6k health on there. So that is a pretty decent roll as well. But then again, it's a skill tier. We can roll whatever we want on there. But yeah, it's a new gear set. I'm definitely gonna buy this. Over to the Sokolov, 9.8% weapon damage, 10.2% critical hit damage, and 17.5% repair skills. And this is very nice, guys. That critical hit damage is pretty decent. That 17.5% repair skills is very nice if you're using this for a solo build, to use that repair skills to keep you alive and then, of course, roll that weapon damage away. This could be a very nice buy. And then, of course, again, a new brand set, guys. Walker Harris & Co. again, 11.7% weapon damage, 10% skill haste and 4.8% critical hit chance. And this could be a very nice one. I would love to see that weapon damage a little bit higher. But yeah, just like you, I'm diving into the vendors and I didn't farm quite yet. So this is a very nice buy to start with, of course. Then over to our first mod, the 8.5% skill duration, pretty decent. Then the 5.9% heal, pretty decent as well. Four stinger charges, nice. Not worth the 73 DZ credits though. Then the 6.3% cone size, pretty decent as well. not that great for that 73 DZ creds, because I think that's a lot. And the last one, 5.9% shock radius for your shock trap. Could be nice, but again, the open world will treat you better. Keep your DZ credits, guys. But yeah, that was the first DZ. Let's quickly head over to the next one. Let's go to South. And then for the South, guys, the first thing we can buy is the Glory Days, 11% assault rifle damage, 12.5% health damage, and 5% damage to armor. And then, of course, that perfect nearsighted on there. This is a very nice roll, in my opinion. Roll that health damage a little bit higher, or of course, to that max cap, and you have a very nice gun. But I don't like that perfect nearsighted on there. There are a lot more talents that are way better. Then we got the Tactical Vector, 11% SMG damage, 11.5% critical hit chance, and 9% magazine size and outsider. In my opinion, leave it here, guys, at magazine size. I'm not fond of it. I would love to see something else on there. Then we got the normal custom P416, 9% assault rifle damage, 12.5% health damage, and 23% optimal range. And Vindictive on there. That optimal range could be very nice, as you can see. I don't have it kept yet, but I don't know if you want an optimal range on your assault rifle. Not when you can roll that damage to armor on there, for example. And next to that, the assault rifle damage is a little bit too low. Next to the health damage, the same. You want both to be a little bit higher to roll just one. Over to the Officer M9. Not that great, it's just a pistol. Just leave it there, guys. Aces of Eights backpack, 10.1% weapon damage and 7.7% explosive resistance. In my opinion, leave it here. You don't want that explosive resistance on there. Then the Eclipse Protocol, the sealed chest guard. 9% skill haste on there, and then profileration. Increased indirect transmission range from 15 to 20 meters and refreshes the percentage from 50 to 75% of the indirect transmission then, of course. So this is a very nice one to have. But then again, I would love to see that skill haste a little bit higher, but you can roll whatever you like on there. So if you're having some bad luck in farming this new gear set, pick it up at the DZs. But don't forget, 109 DZ creds. It's pretty high up there. Then we got the new Walker & Harris & Co. Backpack, the Horizon Rucksack. 10.2% weapon damage, 8.5% skill haste, and 15.1k health on there, and opportunistic on there. In my opinion, leave it here. It could be a little bit higher, in my opinion. Then we got the Yall Vest. This could be nice. Almost 140k armor, 4.7% headshot damage, and 9% status effect, and unbreakable on there. And it has a red mod. So that could be very nice. Roll that headshot damage away for something else, or even if you want to go for all red core, roll that armor away for weapon damage then, of course. But then that 4.7% headshot damage is not high enough, in my opinion. Over to the mods, 7.3% headshot damage, pretty decent, but farm it for the open world, guys. Don't go for the DZ creds for mods, or not for this one for the headshot damage. Two bombs, again, leave it here. Then we got a 5.8% duration, again, leave it here. Open world mods, guys, this is too expensive. 73 DZ creds, and we can only get up to that 300. Then the 4.3% skill haste, again, just leave it there, guys, leave it there. But let's get over to our last vendor, and of course, last DZ vendor. So for the DZ West, guys, the Harmony, the new rifle, is the first thing we can buy. It has 10% rifle damage, 11% critical hit damage, and 18% optimal range on there. And then, of course, the new talent, perfectly in sync. Hitting an enemy grants 20% skill damage for 5 seconds. Using a skill or damaging an enemy with a skill grants 20% weapon damage for 5 seconds. Damages increased are doubled, while buffs are active at the same time. So this is a very, very nice new talent, but in my opinion, don't go for this weapon yet. That rifle damage is a little bit too low, the critical hit damage could be a little bit higher, and yeah, you would love to see some other things on there than optimal range. It sounds great for a rifle, but a rifle already has a pretty decent range, so you don't want that optimal range on there, in my opinion, then of course. Next one is the custom M870, the shotgun with 12% shotgun damage, 10% damage to armor, and 6.8% stability, and ignited on there. Leave it here, guys. 101 DZ creds, way too high in my opinion. And then over to the UIC-15, 9% rifle damage, 13% critical hit damage, and 9.5% magazine size and future perfect on there. You can buy it for the future perfect, but in my opinion, leave it here. 101 DZ credits is way too much just for talent, because you don't want this roll. The rifle damage is too low and you don't want that magazine size. Over to the Eclipse Protocol. Yes, we can buy it again. And this one is a pretty nice roll, because this already has an 8.7% status effect on there. If you don't have it this high just yet in your library, definitely pick this up, guys. We can almost buy a whole 4-piece Eclipse Protocol. Then over to the Striker's Knee Pads, 9.6% weapon damage and almost 4k armor generation on there. Just leave it there. Weapon damage is too low and you don't want that armor regeneration on there, in my opinion. Then over to the Alps Summit Gloves, 7.2% skill haste and 7.2% headshot damage. Too low in my opinion, leave it here. Knee pads from Fenris aren't that great. 8.8% weapon damage, you can quit there in my opinion, because the rest need to be god rolled to buy this. Then over to the 11% protection from elites, and this could be a very nice one. I farmed a long time for that 12%, so this is a pretty decent buy, but again, these are mods, guys, and I don't know if you want to spend your 73 DZ creds on it. Over to the 6.3% health, again, 73 DZ creds, not worth it in my opinion. 1% damage bonus per enemy, not worth it at all. 5.7% skill haste for your drone could be nice, but again, just for the mods, go in the open world, guys. Just like the 6% duration for your decoy could be nice, but 73 DZ creds. If you're only in the DZ, of course, pick this up, because you, if you are full up, you're full up. There is a max on the DZ creds. But yeah, guys, damn. That's pretty much it for this week's vendor reset. Maybe there will be a maintenance and the whole vendors will change again. And of course, I will keep you updated on that. I will see if I can do it a little bit shorter next time. But guys, for today, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.